Hi, my name is Aaron Powell. I'm a principal cloud advocate here at Microsoft, and today we're going to talk about arrow functions in JavaScript. An arrow function, or something you might be familiar with, a fat arrow function, is a special type of function declaration that we've got in JavaScript. A function is normally defined using the function keyword, but an arrow function is defined using an equal symbol and the greater than symbol following it immediately. That's why it gets its name, fat arrow. The special thing about an arrow function is that it changes the way that the this context is managed within inside of a JavaScript function. If you've worked with JavaScript functions before, you might have seen that the this value inside of that function is determined by its parent scope. So it can catch you out on where that function was called to what this actually represents. Inside of a fat arrow function, it captures its parent's this context and makes that available because an arrow function doesn't have a this context of its own. Instead, it inherits it from its parent or its parent's parent or its parent's parent, etc., depending on where the most top level non-arrow function is defined. An arrow function also supports implicit return values. This means you don't need to use the keyword return to return a value out of an arrow function if it's only a single line. An arrow function can also be assigned to a variable, so we would do const add equals and then our arrow function, or it can be immediately used. We can't just have a named function like we would with a traditional JavaScript function because it has to be assigned to a variable. One of the other benefits is it's a reduction in the number of characters you've got to type, or the number of characters that are in the output JavaScript, and thus a smaller bundle size you might be sending down in a browser response. Let's have a look at a couple of different use cases for an arrow function. On the first set of examples, we'll see we're creating an add function. We're assigning that to a variable called add using a const keyword, and then it has two arguments, A and B, and then our arrow operator, and then A plus B. Now this doesn't have a return statement, and it's also only a single line, which an arrow function then deems as an implicit return value. So when we were to do a console.log on that add function, it will give us the value of 3. Now we can still have a multi-line and explicit return for our arrow function, and that's what we're doing with our subtract variable. So subtract is assigned to an arrow function, and this time we're using the curly brackets to denote that this is going to take multiple lines. And here we then have the explicit return, not an implicit return, by using the return keyword. Now you could imagine you could have other things that this function is also doing, but in this case, it's still only a single line. And then if we were to call it, we would call it the same way we would call the add function, just by invoking that function and passing in some arguments. As I mentioned before, the this context changes with inside of an arrow function, and it's important to understand what that means. This context in a traditional JavaScript function is defined where that function is called, whereas in an arrow function, it's inherited from its parent. So if it is invoked inside of the callback for a callback handler, such as a click event or an asynchronous operation, then it will be wherever that function was defined as passed as an argument to the callback, that is where the this context will be. This means that inside of an arrow function, you're less likely to rely on this because it's always inherited somewhere up in the hierarchy of the definition of that function, and it's not something you can control with inside of your own scope. Because you cannot actually change the way that this context is defined with inside of an arrow function. In other JavaScript functions, you have some control over that, but this is always explicitly defined by its parent. And it's also maintained if you pass this function as a reference to another function. So this is where you would pass it as the callback handler to something that's going to happen asynchronously, whether it's a set timeout. The this scope is always going to be defined by its parent, and it could be passing that so on and so forth to many different locations where you have so far removed from where it was originally defined, but that this scope is originally captured from its declaration point. And if we're dealing with our return values, we can have them implicit or explicit. A single line arrow function will always be implicit returned, even if the result of the operation returns nothing, it returns an undefined, then the return value of your implicit statement is going to be undefined. If you want to make an arrow function over multiple lines, then we would use the curly brackets that would then denote the start and end of the block that is that function. And then everything within inside of those curly brackets are the block statements that we have. This is similar to a traditional JavaScript function.